Good evening to everybody, and thank you for coming and attending this event. I would like to thank Michael very much, and of course the Mideast Freedom Forum Berlin and its staff for organizing this event, and to continue my thanking, of course, to the university, which already hosting this event. I will give probably just a few minutes and a background about myself. I am a Palestinian who born in the old city of Jerusalem. And I've grown up for 33 years in a refugee camp in the north of Jerusalem. So I suffered as the other Palestinian refugees are suffering. And probably this is one of the reasons why I became such, let's say, a peaceful man, because I am a person who don't believe in violence. And I am a person who believe all the time that only via negotiations we probably will be able to solve our problems and our conflict. I would like to use this opportunity and probably to start my speech from Gaza. Gaza looks like today as the hell on earth. I don't think that anybody around the world want to be under the situation of the Gaza. But if we will look to inside Gaza today, we will find that there are four different players playing inside the Gaza. Two players are very interesting in the destruction and the destroying of the Gaza Strip. And another two players who are interesting in the reconstruction of the Gaza Strip. The Egyptian government and the Palestinian Authority of the West Bank are very interested in destroying the Gaza Strip. Why? The Egyptian government believes that the Hamas organization is a terrorist organization. The Egyptian government believes that while we will impose more and more pressure on the Gaza Strip, this is the only way how to get rid from the Hamas organization. What is the interest of the Palestinian Authority of the West Bank in destroying Gaza? The Palestinian Authority also believes that while Egypt imposing more and more pressure on Gaza, that's it probably will pave the way to the Palestinian Authority to return back to Gaza and to rule Gaza like they used to do till 2007. Now, who are the other two players who are interested in the reconstruction of Gaza? Hamas, of course, one, and Israel is the second. Why Israel is interested in the reconstruction of Gaza? Because that's a source of income. That will bring billions of dollars, because Israel is the one who is going to sell the building material to Gaza. Now, if the Hamas and Israel almost agreed on the reconstruction of Gaza, where is the conflict here? The conflict is that the Hamas said that the priority for the reconstruction of Gaza should have to go to our own tunnels and to our military capability. While Israel said, no way, the priority for the reconstruction of Gaza should have to go to the houses and to the other civil facilities which has been destroyed during the 2014. And this is unfortunately how the whole process of the reconstruction of Gaza almost delayed for 3.5 years. If we will look, friends, to the Rafah passage, which is dividing Gaza from Egypt, during the last year, 2017, the Rafah passage was open only for 20 days. During all of the year. How many Palestinians succeed to cross from Gaza to inside Egypt during the last year? 20,000 only. If we will move to 2011, how many Palestinians succeed to cross from Gaza to inside Egypt through the Rafah passage? 460,000. So the number dropped from about 500,000 to 20,000 only. And that's showing the real pressure that Egypt is trying to impose on the Gaza Strip. Right now, every year, we hear about a new initiative, how to bring the Palestinians together and to create unity and reconciliation between the Fatah and the Hamas. We almost signed, in the past 11 years, we almost signed 6 different agreements. And still we are interested in more agreements. What's happened? Nothing. Right now it's freezing. Why it is freezing? Because neither the Hamas nor the Fatah are interested in any kind of reconciliation. And the only one who is interested in the reconciliation between the Fatah and the Hamas is the Egyptian government. Why the Egyptian government is interested to bring reconciliation between the Fatah and the Hamas? Because the Egyptian government wants the Palestinian Authority to return back and to rule Gaza. Why the Egyptians are interested to bring back the Palestinian Authority to Gaza? Because recently, the Egyptian government found that the terrorists who are fighting inside Sinai, their financial support is coming through Gaza. So the Egyptians intend to cut and to block the financial support from Gaza to Sinai. They want the Palestinian Authority to replace the Hamas in the Gaza Strip and mainly to take responsibility on the borders. But looks like that Egypt didn't succeed right now, because the lack of the goodwill of the Palestinians themselves to reach any kind of reconciliation among themselves. If we will move to the West Bank a little bit, I am a person who believes that if Mr. Netanyahu tomorrow morning will meet with President Abbas, it probably the first question Netanyahu will ask Abbas, whom you are representing, Mr. President? West Bank, Gaza Strip, or Palestinians diaspora? I believe that the President Abbas only representing his 2 sons and his wife. I think that there is a huge lack of trust these days between the Palestinians and their own leadership. And I'm not talking about the West Bank, only also about Gaza. I think that the Palestinians, the majority of the Palestinians, lost the trust in their own leadership. If you will come today to any ordinary Palestinian and asking him, what are the 3 priorities that you are seeking? he will say a job to survive, to secure the education system and the health system for my children. Nobody is talking about settlements. Nobody is talking about the wall. Nobody even talking about the foundation of the Palestinian state. Which means that the majority of the Palestinians these days are people who are seeking dignity rather than identity. I used to teach my Palestinian colleagues in the refugee camps every day that homeland is not the place where you born. Homeland is the place where you can find dignity, justice, and freedoms. Any country around the world will assure me these three important things, I have no problem to be considered as their own citizen. Dignity, justice, and freedoms. This is the real homeland, friends. If we will look today to the Middle East map, and how the Islamic terror is increasing, we will find that the Israeli-Palestinian conflict is probably the most safe place in the Middle East. As a Muslim, as an Arab, I don't want to be in Libya. I don't want to be in Iraq. I don't want to be in Syria. And I don't want to be in Yemen. It's much more safe for myself and for my children to continue living under the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. Arabs today almost stuck in their own mud. There is no more Arabs countries today. It's just a name. But in fact, as a country, it does not exist. And that's reminding me in 1977, when the former Egyptian president Anwar Sadat visited Israel. He gave an interview for one of the Israeli newspapers there. And the interviewer, the Israeli journalist, asked Sadat, how many Arab countries are in the world? And Sadat said, one Arab country, the Arab Republic of Egypt. Then the journalist asked, what about the others? Then Sadat said, the others are tribes with flags. Looks like that this is the reality. We are tribes. Each tribe now is looking for his own emirate or his own country or his own whatever he call it. Sunni, Shia, Turkman, Kurdish, I don't know whatever. Each one wants his own country. This is the situation of the Arabs. And looks like that the Palestinians right now has no backing from any Arab country. We are alone in the courtyard. And if our leadership will not start planning and finding a kind of strategy towards the future, that will be considered as another tragedy to the Palestinians. I think that terror today is the priority of the international community, not the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. And I totally agree with that. Because I think that the Palestinians and the Israelis should have to move a little bit from under the lines. Because while we are under the lights, we are not the owners of the conflict. And this conflict has a lot of foreign fingers are playing in it. Imagine when the Fatah and the Hamas want to reach any kind of reconciliation among themselves, Qatar in the Gulf, contacting Hamas, giving $50 million by saying, don't agree with Fatah. This is the real tragedy of the Palestinians. I think that the international community should have to meet among themselves and to start evaluating their foreign policy towards the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. If the international community will continue with their current policy, that will be a tragedy to the Palestinians and to the Israelis. I think that the international community committed a huge mistakes here on the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. And I wish one day that we, the Israelis and the Palestinians, will get rid from the international community. Any kind of aid or any kind of help, please, you can provide. But don't ever interfere in the conflict itself. Don't ever try to impose any kind of solutions in the Israeli-Palestinian. Because the only owners of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict are the Israelis and the Palestinians only. If we will have the opportunity to have the conflict in our own hands, I believe it will be much easier to solve it than it is in the hands of the others. I am a person who is traveling worldwide, from the Philippines to Chile in Latin America, trying to spread a very specific message. And the message is that we need more and more economic prosperity. We don't want politics. We don't want initiatives. We don't want conferences. We need economic prosperity. I am a person who believes that with economic prosperity, it probably we will be able to pave the way towards peace. All initiatives almost failed. All conferences almost failed. All the agreements that we signed almost failed. What remains, and giving a little bit of hope, is the economic prosperity. This is what we need. And this is exactly my message to the Israeli government everywhere. That when the Israeli government will increase the Palestinian economy, that probably will decrease the Palestinian violence. Because a lot of youth Palestinians today are seeking jobs. They want to work. They want to survive. And this is also the same message to the international community. We need jobs. We need economic prosperity. We need it better. Level of life. And that's exactly what the international community should have to start looking into it. Unfortunately, while we are calling for economic prosperity, we have such horrible organizations, which is called the BDS. I think that the BDS interest is how to destroy the Palestinian economy. I don't believe that the BDS will bring for any kind of peace between the Israelis and the Palestinians. While you are calling to destroy my economy, I just have to react at the destroying the existing of that organization. I am living in the terrorists. I know exactly what is going on. When we are losing jobs, nobody around the world offering us jobs. And there are several thousands of Palestinians almost lost their jobs because of the activity of the BDS. And I didn't see that the BDS ever tried to offer any kind of help to those Palestinians who lost their jobs. Friends, first of all, we don't have BDS neither in the West Bank nor in the Gaza Strip, by the way, because it is not a comfortable place to act in. We are not donating money. These people want money. When they want money, they should have to act either in Europe or in the United States, even not in any Arab country. So we don't have them. You probably have them. And they are affecting you rather than they are affecting me. I think that this is a very important issue.
BDS is boycott, divestment, sanctions
against
Israel. Trying to boycott Israel or the settlement.
I think that this is a very important issue that you should have to stand up against it because it's causing damage to us. You shouldn't have to support such kind of organizations. Unfortunately, these people became so activist, so active at the universities in Europe and especially in the United States. I was over than 700 different universities around the United States. I saw these people when they used to come and to demonstrate inside the room where I am speaking. But I am strong enough to stand up and to continue speaking and to continue protesting whatever the BDS is doing. Friends, if such organizations are organizations who are trying to keep the Palestinians as hostages in turn to gain power and money. It's not different than the UN, it's not different than UNRWA, it's not even different than UNESCO. What we the Palestinians really achieving from these so-called international organizations? What we are achieving? We achieve nothing. And these people just trying more and more how to keep themselves survive while they are keeping us hostages under the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. I think that it is the time right now to wake up. Not only countries, not only leaders, but also individuals and communities and societies. This is very important. If you want to help really the Palestinians and the Israelis to solve their conflict, try to prevent any intervention from outside to the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. We know exactly how to solve it, and we know exactly when to solve it. So it is up to us, not up to anybody who is living outside the conflict. I will stop probably right now and giving you the opportunity to ask me some questions. Thank you very much.